What was some of your early perceptions of Michael Jordan, and did you guys have any, like, one-on-one games back in the day?
No, we didn't do the one-on-one, but we played together in the pro-am at Chicago State for about 7 or 8 years. So we would be on the same team, and we either won or co-shared the MVP every year we won in that tournament, because our team wound up in the championship just about every year we were playing together. But my initial guess was I think the best way to put it was, I remember we were going over game plan, playing the Bulls, I believe, in Chicago. And I remember Coach Nelson, Don Nelson, saying, okay, after everything had been done, he said, now I'm going to just warn you all, this kid is really, really good. He said, so the thing that you have to guard against is that you don't get caught watching him instead of playing defense. And that was like one of the things. I was like, he cannot be that good. You know, and this was before he and I met and started playing together in the pro-am. But he was every bit of that. I mean, he was so quick, and he got off his feet so quick, you know. And I remember at the top of the key, we were supposed to trap the pick and roll, and I jumped out too quick. He slid in between me and the other guy setting the trap, took one dribble into the lane and dunked on the whole team. And I said, okay, I get it. You know, I get it. You cannot watch this cat. You got to do your job, you know. And early on, we were at Milwaukee in position. We pretty much beat them the first few years we played them in any playoff-type game, you know. And that was before I think Mike figured it out. But as a player and as a person, I mean, just, you know, good people. And, I mean, can't even begin to speak to his talent and ability. And that's not blowing his horn. That's just out of respect. I mean, I didn't go there in any game against Mike and play anything less than my best game. And he was still Mike. You know, he still did what he did. The stage was set for Mike for players like, you know, by players like who were high flyers like Julius Erving. And there were a lot of cats that actually could get off the floor like him, but they just didn't have the ingenuity and the creativity that he had with the ball. The closest thing to him was Dr. J, or vice versa, depending on how you look at it. But Mike just took it to another level, you know, and he was the reason why the game really sped the way it did initially. And all the rest of the players, including myself, that played, were beneficiaries of it.
Make sure to subscribe to the channel, hit the bell for notifications, like, comment, share. Also, go over to UGSForLife.com, download the entire archive, and check out new episodes on Apple Podcasts and Blog Talk Radio.